Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Friday. Welcome to Friday Favorites and Flops. I hope you all had a really good week. I have had a good week myself. It's actually my birthday week, so my birthday's tomorrow. I'm gonna be 43, which still kind of blows my mind that I'm already in my 40s. I actually still very vividly remember turning 23 and whooping it up with my girlfriends at the club. That was such a long time ago, but it also in some ways seems like it was just yesterday. Time's a crazy thing. It's a weird thing. The older you get, the faster it goes. Anyway, I'm really looking forward to this next year. I tell you what, just a little pep talk, probably for myself as much as some of you out there who maybe are struggling a little bit. Every year for my birthday, I try to set a couple of like goals or like resolutions for the next year of my life. I haven't really put much thought into what I want to do this next year at 43. I did make some pretty big changes in my floral business this past, fall. And, I don't know if my like goals should kind of revolve around revamping that somehow, or I don't know. I just have no idea. But the wonderful thing about being in my 40s, though, that I love the most is that I feel like I am the most confident that I've ever been in my entire life. I used to be one of those people that would just watch what other people are doing, like my peers, and I would be like, oh, I have to do the same thing, or oh, I have to do it that way. And guess what? You don't. You don't have to do anything the way that anybody else does it. You can just do it your own way. I feel like it wasn't until I got into my 40s that I was like, oh yeah, I can live my own life. I don't have to do things the way that other people do them. And it's great. It's great. If you are in your late 20s and you're just kind of like, ugh, like life's just kind of getting you down, I would say get the confidence that I finally now have at 40 earlier and just make your 30s rock, or whatever age you are. Just, you know what? Stop thinking about what other people think about you and just kind of do your own thing. It's great. It's really nice. I highly, highly recommend it. So anyway, I think part of my goal for this next year is just to continue that, like just to continue to grow as a person and be confident in myself, do my own thing, even if that's like not necessarily like the proper thing to do or maybe perceived as like the right thing to do by certain people. If it makes you happy, do it. As long as you're not hurting anybody else. I mean, if you're out here like, you know, doing awful things to other people, you should stop doing that. But if you're not hurting anyone, live your life, be happy, be content. That's what I'm gonna do. That's probably another one of my main goals for this next year, is just continue to grow and be happy and try to be as content as possible, even when life throws some major curveballs your way, which a lot of us have had over the last couple years. So I think it's just nice to like recommit yourself to positivity and growth and being a good person. So anyway, there's your pep talk for the day. Now we're gonna get into my Friday faves. I'm gonna try to go as quickly as possible here because quite frankly, I have a lot of projects that I have half done around the house right now and I should finish those so that I don't walk past them and keep going, oh, I should finish that. So let's get into it. Okay, first off, my perfume pick of the week. I actually recommended this in my Sephora sale suggestions video that went up earlier this week. If you missed it, I will link that down below. I love this perfume, you guys. This is the Vanilla Woods from the Seven Virtues. Oh, I've mentioned this multiple times on my channel, and many of you have gotten this perfume just based on my recommendations, and you let me know that you love it as well. It's heavenly. It's a warm, cozy, like romantic vanilla scent. It's not overly sweet. It has some sweetness to it. It also has a little bit of like a cashmere musk type vibe. It's just very warm and inviting and cozy. And whenever I wear this, I get a lot of compliments. And I really like how long this particular scent lasts on me. It's probably one of my longer lasting perfumes. I love it. It's beautiful. I'm already like Do I need another one? I am past the halfway point. That's pretty good. I have a lot of perfumes, you guys. And so when I finish a perfume, it's a huge deal because I have a lot of perfumes. My collection is kind of getting out of control. I'm actually thinking that I might retire some of my older perfumes. That's hard to do though, because I just love them all. I don't know. Anyway, moral of the story is this is fantastic. If you haven't tried it, you should. Okay, I finished what did I finish this week? It was the Kenra Gold Leave-In. I shared it in my Friday faves either last week or the week before. I love that leave-in. It's fantastic. I will repurchase that. But since I finished that, I was able to go to my backup closet and get out something that I haven't used in a long time, and I forget how much I love this product. This is from Alterna. This is the Caviar Anti-Aging Replenishing Moisture CC Cream 10-in-1 Complete Correction Leave-In. Cream. It's a leave-in. This does so many things for your hair. It moisturizes, it provides shine, smoothness, softness, UV protection, manageability, strength, anti-breakage, heat protection, and light hold. It's wonderful. If you've never tried this, a little bit goes a long way, but this protects my hair so beautifully. I love the smell of it. Oh, I love the smell of it. I love that Alterna smell. It's like a very specific scent, and it just makes me happy when I smell it. But this is great. If you've never tried this, I would think, especially if you can get 20% off of it, this is totally worth a try. If you like testing out different leave-ins for your hair, this one has always been a rock star product for me. I originally discovered this because Sephora was giving out 100-point perks that were samples of this. And I think I used like 900 points to get like 9 of these like sample tubes. This was many years ago when they still allowed you to like get a bunch of like the same thing. I feel like they cut you off now on that. But anyway, loved it, fell in love with it and started buying it and just have repurchased it multiple times since then. It's to die for. It's wonderful. Highly, highly recommend. Let's talk some makeup. First off, look what I busted out from like back in the day. How long have you guys been here? How long have some of you been subscribed? Some of you have been here forever. And man, do I love you for it, because I know how easy it is to like get bored with a channel and move on. And I'm not gonna lie, sometimes when people like either leave or stop commenting, sometimes I think like, oh, I miss that person. I hope they're doing well in life. Like I do, like I miss people when I don't hear from them. But anyway, Everyday Minerals. I used to really be into this Everyday Minerals. And I had to make sure that the company was still around, and they are. This is their semi-matte base. It is a powder foundation, obviously. And I busted this out. I don't even know why, but I was using it this week and I love this powder foundation. I am in Golden Ivory 1W. This is kind of the perfect color for me, but look at the really nice glow that this gives my skin. I would say this is kind of on par with the glow that I get from the Laura Geller Balance and Brighten. This is great. And this one you can get some really good coverage with if you need it. They have a matte base. I don't recommend the matte base. It's very matte, like even more matte than I like. And I like a matte look. And then they also have their jojoba base. If you are super dry, you should try their jojoba formula. Very hydrating, very moisturizing in terms of a powder foundation. But this semi-matte is kind of like the perfect in between the two. And if you've never checked these guys out, if you're into mineral powder foundation, you should try them. They're wonderful. Their setting powders are really nice too. I think I at one point had some of their blushes. I think I gifted the blushes away. A mineral blush, like a loose mineral blush, that's messy. that's not for me. But yeah, Everyday Minerals. Wow, they're still around. They still make a great powder foundation. I love it. So I'm so glad I decided to go digging through my Alex 9 drawer here and just look for something new. I think I was just bored with my current powder foundations. They're all great. They're my favorites. But, you know, sometimes you just crave something new. And that was wonderful this week. My blush for the week, what I have going on now, is this. This is from Kiko Milano. I hope this is still available. The Kiko Milano stuff sells out pretty quickly on the Ulta website, I feel like. I don't know if this blush is still available, but if it is, you should get it because it's a gorgeous mauve. You can see, I'm wearing it, but there's a swatch. Oh my God, am I gonna have a coughing attack? Please don't. Craig was sick earlier this week, just with like a cold. And I feel like I had it too, but mine was really minor. I was joking with him. I was like, my immune system is way better than yours. Cause he was struggling. Craig was on the couch for like 2 days, like at the start of this week, and just did not really get up. And I was like, just bebopping around the house doing my usual stuff. But anyway, hopefully I don't have a coughing fit here. So this is the Charming Escape Silky Blush in Mallow Field. Oh, this is so pretty, you guys. I love this. And here's the thing, it's super pigmented. Do not like, don't do this with your brush, like tippity tap, and then make sure that you get rid of that excess and then put it on. Cause you will get looking like a clown real fast with this one. If you don't, it's very pigmented, but it's fabulous. Stays put a decently long time. It is not as good as my Hourglass blushes. It's not as good as the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12 hour blush. Those I would say are still probably my faves, but this is really good for like a drugstore blush. Love it. On my lips today and most of this week has been this. This is the Buxom Full Force lipstick in White Russian. This is just kind of like a nice neutral pink. It's pink, has like, it's like a pinky nude. So it's not too like bright. I feel like it's still very wearable and I feel like it's appropriate this time of year, but I just wanted something like kind of lighter on my lips and this just kind of fit the bill. So I love it, it's wonderful. Okay, I am testing out this new mascara from Wander Beauty. They did send this to me. From time to time, Wander Beauty sends me like a few PR items, and they sent their new upgraded lashes. This is their treatment mascara, you guys. First of all, the formula is fantastic. I love this formula. This is supposed to be a lash conditioning formula that helps keep your lashes attached longer, just really nicely conditioned. The formula is buildable, so I get a decent amount of volume from this, but I was really surprised by how much I liked this wand. I don't normally love these plastic bristle wands. It's one of these numbers here. Can you guys see that? It's not the traditional, like, what are they, like nylon bristles. It's the plastic ones, but it's got like, if you look at it from some angles, it's got like an hourglass shape. And then when you look at it from others, it's got more of like a like football type shape, I guess. So you've got lots of different bristle lengths and shapes, if you will. It just makes it really easy to get to the base of your lashes and wiggle up. A great, great volumizing mascara. I really like this. Little bit of length as well, but I like the fact that it has those like good for your lashes type benefits. So I'm excited to use this a little bit more long term and see if it really does help to condition my lashes. It does not cause any flaking. There's no smudging, there's no transfer. The formula is a little wet when you're first getting started with it, but it's not unworkable wet. Like I hate mascara where you put it on and it's just like a slick of mascara and then you have to use like a lash comb to like comb it all out and just try to separate your lashes again. Hate mascara like that. That's typically why I don't buy lengthening mascaras, because those are the ones that tend to do that the most to me. Volumizing formulas are my favorite. This doesn't say it's a volumizing formula, but it gives me good volume. I really like this. For my eyeshadows this week, I have just been wearing my Sydney Grace shadows, these guys right here. These are wonderful eyeshadows, you guys. The thing is, they're super affordable when you buy them like individually. They're, I think, $6, somewhere around there. But by the time that you buy like 5 or 6 or like a palette's worth, you're probably paying roughly the same amount as you would for like an eyeshadow palette at Sephora and Ulta, but that's okay. They're still really great quality. I think they're fantastic. And I like the fact that you can obviously just purchase the shades that you want. They're sold as singles. And a couple of the shades that I was loving this week were Troops. Ooh, Troops right here. Kind of reminds me a little bit of MAC Satin Taupe. I was also loving this matte shade up here, Cool Brown. Have that in my crease right now. Another shade that I have in my crease that I've been enjoying is Embrace, this guy right here. It's kind of a pinky mauve, really nice. And what's another one? I was using this one over top of Troops a little bit, which is Collective. Isn't that pretty? It's got a little bit more purple than the Troops, but they're very similar. So, so beautiful. Anyway, these shadows are fantastic. Love them. Took me a long time to commit to trying Sydney Grace shadows, and some of you just kept pushing and pushing and saying, you really should. And you were right. They are wonderful. I love their shimmers. Their mattes are really blendable. There's quite a bit of fallout, which I think is kind of a turnoff, but it's workable for me because I use powder foundation, so I can just brush things away. But if you are a liquid foundation person, just do your eyeshadow before your foundation and you should be fine, because then you can just wipe it away with like a makeup wipe or whatever. But yeah, these are great. And I have them in this Tarte palette. I think this Tarte palette is still available. If it is, you have to get some of these. They're so cheap right now. They're like, I think $6 at this point, either $10 or $6. And they come with a huge mirror. They hold a ton of shadows. So if you want to depot some of your larger palettes, this is a great way to do it. Love. And then the last thing I want to recommend is the U Beauty Resurfacing Compound. I am just now coming to the end of my little sample size. By the way, the Skin Store Holiday Advent calendar is, they've had to delay it a couple times. You can pre-order it though. I will put the information for that thing in the description box down below, as well as a discount code if you want to pre-order it. I should have it within the next week or two to actually be able to show you guys what comes in this year's advent calendar, but this is one of the items that's included in there, and it's fabulous. There's 0.33 fluid ounces in here, but I swear I've been using this for weeks. A little bit goes a long way, and this is a wonderful resurfacer for the skin. If you are dealing with texture, this just gets rid of it for you. I feel like this improves the look of pores. I feel like it gives my skin a beautiful glow the next day after using it the night before. I do only use this at night. This does have some acids in it, so just for me, I prefer to use those in the evening. So on the nights where I haven't been using my tretinoin, I've been incorporating this. It's great. It's really expensive. I did, by the way, purchase the full size of this from, was it Neiman Marcus? Somewhere had it on sale for like $125. For an ounce. And it's expensive, but you know what? I spent that money because I had this sample and fell in love with it just based on the sample. So that just goes to show you, some things are worth splurging on. And this was worth splurging on for me. So I have a full size in my backup stash that as soon as I finish this, I'm gonna bust out. It's great. It's great. And if you wanna try a sample of it, I believe there is a sample of this, and probably in the same size in that Skin Store edit. Anyway, I'll put the link down below. All right, you guys, that's everything that I have for you. I'm gonna get going, and I need to clean my house. So I hope you have a fantastic weekend. I do have a bunch of home fragrance content coming up, so if you're interested in that kind of stuff, that's gonna be going up over the weekend. I've pre-recorded all that, so it's all ready to go. And I'm gonna enjoy my birthday weekend with just a nice dinner with my husband, and just turn another year older. So here's to it. Have a great one, you guys, and I'll see you the next time. Take care. Toodaloo.